Hey guys, it's Adam here. I'm just going to do a quick intro before you go ahead and watch this movie. What I've got here for you is a full-length feature film that I edited over the course of 2 months that is a service for all of you, because I knew at some point I was going to reach 10,000 subscribers and I wanted to give this to you guys as a gift. Hopefully you like Jurassic Park. What I did was I recorded this game all the way through and turned it into a movie. And I think it really holds up as a cohesive film. Please, you know, let me know in the comments. It is owned by Universal Studios and Telltale Games. I in no way have an association with either of them, nor does my company, FigureItOut Productions. We have nothing to do with these guys. Like I said, just a labor of love that I just wanted to share with you guys. So all you need to know going into this is that you need to have at least seen the first film. You don't necessarily have to have seen the second or third, but you might as well. It takes place during and after that movie. So without further ado, please enjoy.
Yeah, it's a great view, but where are the dinosaurs?
There should be triceratops out there. Sometimes they're kind of hard to spot.
Oh, yeah?
Where'd you get those?
These?
Yeah, those.
That, guy gave them to me, your boss, John Hammer, or whatever. He likes me.
That was generous of him.
There's a car down there.
Must be Hammond's visitors. He's got some hotshot paleontologists here to see the park.
I bet they get to see some dinos up close. Wouldn't it be, like, educational if I stuck around here another day or two?
You know, I think your mom might miss you a bit.
Are you kidding me? She'd be, like, totally happy.
Oh, come on. No, she wouldn't.
Yeah, she would. Wait, I definitely see one. Oh, he just ran away.
Actually, it's a she. They're all female. So, which way did she go?
I see her. Wait. There's a bunch of them. Oh, awesome. They're fighting. I totally wanted to see this.
Well, actually, it's more of a dominance display than a fight. You remember how patchy was when your mom got that new puppy? Lady Margaret's like that with the younger Triceratops.
Seriously? Lady Margaret?
Yep, that's what we call the alpha. See those horns? They're more than 3 feet long.
Good for fighting T-Rex, right? When do we get to see that?
That's not gonna happen. I'm busy enough without holding gladiator fights. Which reminds me, remember I said I've got a sick Triceratops to check on? I should get going. I'll drop you at the guest house.
Really? Already?
Well, it'll give you some time to pack your stuff. The boat leaves tonight, remember?
I don't have any stuff. I practically just got here.
Well, at least you got to see Triceratops fight. Let's hope for clear skies tonight. No fun on that boat when the waves are rough.
I told you, Nedry isn't here. Fat bastard's probably stuck in a doorway somewhere. Don't worry about it. Plan B is ready. I have Plan B right here. Nedry's not gonna double-cross us. The money's too good. No, she doesn't know your name. She doesn't know anything she doesn't need to know. What, do you think it matters? Hey, guess who's on the line? It's Dodgson. I got Dodgson here. She doesn't care. Come on, my contact's gonna be here any minute.
Does InGen know you stole their jacket?
This is a covert op. I gotta blend in.
So what about me?
Just, follow my lead.
What's in the photo?
This is what's gonna make us both rich. It's what we're here to collect.
Shaving cream.
Uh-huh, sure. Shaving cream. Son of a... Okay, I guess we're going in after him. Ow! InGen should have paved this whole island.
InGen should never have come here. This monstrosidad. InGen is ruining the island. Is it so important to keep people out?
Yeah, it's more about keeping things in. It's sort of like a zoo, you know what I mean?
For what?
Don't worry about it. There's nothing, you know, dangerous in there. Just find a way through.
What does your little toy have to say?
It's a portable tracking system, sweetheart. And it says that we're damn close to that canister.
The light's off.
Yeah, I bet that means the power's out, right?
Maybe.
Yeah, for sure. Ladies first. Oh, thank God. I mean, you know, it's just... Lead the way. What is it?
¿Qué es esto? Like a bird, but much too big.
I told you, it's a zoo. All kinds of animals. Come on, get moving. We're close. Did you hear that? What was that?
An animal. Something I've never heard before.
Okay, well, let's... We should... Oh, God!
That animal, I know.
I hate this damn jungle.
This way.
This is it. The signal's topped out. It's nearby.
Over there.
There we go. Hey, Nedry! You get stuck or something? Nedry, you deaf? I'm not climbing that in my new Stavonis. Yeah, I'm gonna go around. It'll be faster.
Somebody in there?
Tired out, huh? I told you it was better to go around.
Look, in the car.
Oh, that's disgusting.
There was something feeding on him. What the hell kind of zoo is this?
Listen, I told you, don't worry about it, okay? It was just some animal. We'll get the canister and then we're out of here. Where is it? I can't find it. Where's the canister? The shaving cream, where is it?
It doesn't matter. We should get out of here.
No, no, no. If we leave now, we don't get paid.
Oh, Dodson's gonna kill me. Is Dodson gonna kill me?
Don't worry about him. Worry about that thing.
I'm worried about it, okay? What am I supposed to do? You know we can't go back empty-handed.
Look there. Footprints. Your man took a walk. We follow his trail like tracking game. That's how we find the canister.
Right. Okay, okay, that makes sense. Oh, but hold on. What if one of those, okay, you look down there and I'll check the car again, just in case.
¿Qué pasó aquí? He slipped and fell in the mud. Glasses. Pobre desgraciado. Blind in the dark. The tracks lead here, but it's too damn dark to see.
This can't be good for my sinuses.
Any luck?
No. Those tracks of yours better lead somewhere, or we're never getting out of here. Come on! Where'd you hide it? Be easy, just meet him at the dock. Yeah.
¿Qué fue eso?
Oh, sick. Oh, just disgusting.
He circled the tree with a winch line. Then something got interested. Something hungry.
Friggin' bugs! Did you find it?
The canister's not here.
Oh, crap. Oh, I'm so screwed.
No, we can't give up. His trail ends back at the car. You must have missed something in there.
Not a chance. I turned that thing inside out. I'm gonna smell like a dead fat dude for a week.
Fine. I'll take a look.
Knock yourself out. I could use some fresh air.
You had a canister just about this size, didn't you? You didn't lose it down below. You had it with you. He came back to the car in a rush. He hit his head, and he fell.
Oh, baby! I knew I'd find you!
You're pretty excited about a can of soap.
Yeah, it's a can of soap. 10 years of research. Millions invested. It's the next wonder of the world. You want a screw in, Jen? This is it. The crown jewels. They lose control of this, they got nothing. They're dinosaur embryos, honey. Don't tell me you thought we were after shaving cream.
Dinosaurs? I don't understand.
You don't need to understand. That'll keep him fresh. What? What's your problem? Oh, crap. Is it gone?
It's gone.
Okay. You see that? That's how you do it. Yeah! That's what you get, you little punk!
Let's get out of here.
Okay, all right. All right, you know the plan. My boys are sending a boat. We bring them the canister. We get paid. We go home.
We cannot walk to the meeting place. Not with these monstros around here.
Right. We'll take the car. Bring down the car. I'll stay here and cover you. Who's afraid now, huh?
Chadwick, move!
No, no, no.
This is the perfect spot.
Got the angles covered. You build a fire.
Hey, you okay?
You idiot! You nearly killed me!
You should have paid attention.
Lights are gone. The lights are out. What?
All we gotta do is start the car and drive out of here.
Start the car? Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. Kid, it won't start! Now what?
I'll fix it.
You're gonna fix the car in the dark?
That's right. That's a loose battery cable. Gracias a Dios. What?
Oh, God.
You're coming to Dallas?
Oh, just to the mainland. I have to be back after the storm. I'll drive you to the airport.
Cool.
Everything okay at home? I mean, how's school going?
I don't know. Boring. I got a big Spanish test coming up.
Jess, your mom told me about the shoplifting.
I was just fooling around. I didn't take anything good. What did she say?
She got scared. You know, seeing her little girl at the police station.
I know, I'm a screw-up.
Sweetheart, no, it's not that at all. I want you to promise
Dad!
Me.
Dad!
Damn it!
Oh my God, is she dead?
No, she's alive, she's breathing. This is strange. It's like some kind of...
Oh.
She needs medical attention. We've got to get her to the visitor center.
Who is she? Do you know her?
I don't recognize her, but it doesn't matter. Were you serious when you said you can drive a stick?
Oh yeah, I can do it. Mom doesn't know, but...
Look, that's all right. Just get yourself up front. Try not to scare me.
Okay.
All right, let's go. Come on, sweetheart. We gotta get her out of here.
did we?
No, we didn't do this. This is something else.
I'm gonna check her vitals. Just take it easy and follow the signs, all right?
Okay, no problem. What's wrong with her eyes?
I don't know. It's like a reaction to a parasitic infection to... God, I don't know, maybe toxoplasmosis. Oh, she's burning up. Okay, I'm gonna get her bandaged up. You okay to keep driving?
Yeah, I'm good. How is she doing?
Well, she's okay, for now. But this toxic alteration just doesn't make sense.
Dad.
Maybe some of the dinosaurs are eating poisonous plants. Jess, why are we stopping?
She's beautiful. She, right?
Right. Well, we're lucky this young one's by herself. Wouldn't want to meet the alpha out here. Lady Margaret, she's pretty protective. We've discovered that family groups emerge even without the usual genetic relationships. Young Triceratops join the family the moment they...
You're ruining it.
Right. Sorry. I'll just be a sec. Wait here.
Yeah.
Easy, girl. How did you get out here, huh? No, you don't. Treatment. Come on, Jesse. We're safe now.
Yeah. Dinosaurs can't get through that door, right?
No, our dinosaurs cannot open doors. Get some sleep, honey.
We have video.
How did you do that?
It's an easy hack. The system's held together with spit and baling wire, like everything else in this damn park. I'll be damned. They must have cycled main power. Why would they do that? Oh, for crying out loud. What was John thinking when he hired that turkey?
The magic word.
Oh, Dennis Nedry. You want a magic word? I've got some just for you. Come on. Of course.
I'm not sure Lady Margaret made it.
All right.
This isn't supposed to happen. One loose trike, okay, but a tyrannosaur? That's beyond unacceptable. I gotta talk to Muldoon and the security team.
So, how are we gonna get to the visitor center?
That's an excellent question. No car and no radio doesn't leave us a lot of options. Well, at least the main power's back on. That should be good for something.
Looks like we're not the only ones who missed the boat. They won't last long in the open. Let's get them out of there.
How do we get to them? We're miles away, and the access road is washed out.
We may be stuck here in the boondocks, but those two are standing right on the main tour loop. Watch this. How long have I been saying this whole park is doomed to catastrophic failure? Okay, little lambs, just wait right there and I'll send a car to fetch you. Eek, wonder if any of this is still working. Well, the marine exhibit's online. Fat lot of good that does us out here.
Somebody knows we're here. Come on, honey, let's get our patient. If you can hear us, we need to go to the visitor center.
Looks like one of them's hurt.
I'm surprised it's only one.
Can't this car go any faster? It's gonna take forever.
Es peligroso.
You've been in an accident. You're safe now. You're gonna be fine. We're taking you to-
Bastardo! Morirás por tus pecados!
Calm down.
What's happening?
She's delirious. She could be hallucinating.
Mariquita! Angelito mío.
She says I'm her angel. Hola, ¿cómo estás?
No sabes cuánto he esperado.
Jess, just keep talking to her. Tell her she needs to relax. She's got to rest.
Mariquita, ¿qué pasa, mi amor?
Usted necesita el descanso.
¿El descanso? Sí, sí. Estoy cansada.
I guess summer school paid off.
Miss Ortega's never gonna believe this.
Huh. It looks like the trunk line at the visitor center is back up.
Does that help us?
Not really, but it might help those folks on the road.
Dad, look!
I think this is our stop.
This concludes our tour. Don't forget to visit the gift shop on your way home.
Hello? Hey, can somebody help us, please?
What happened? Where is everybody?
Well, the boat hasn't brought everyone back yet. Rough waters, maybe. That sickle claw on the second digit. Velociraptor. What the hell happened here?
Someone's trying to contact us, right?
It's coming from the PA system. They must be broadcasting on the emergency channel. Hang on, I'm gonna track this down. Hello? Hello? This is Jerry Harding. I'm the chief veterinarian.
I know who you are. This is Laura Sorkin. I hope you enjoyed the ride.
Dr. Sorkin, you're still on the island?
We're stuck in the field lab. The road's washed out and our phone lines are down. What's your story?
We saw a T-Rex on the tour road. My daughter and I are lucky to be alive. Do you know what's going on?
Security went down last night. Naturally, the park's going to hell. Looks like Hammond already evacuated. I don't think he meant to leave us.
No, of course not. I'll try to call the mainland from here. They'll send a helicopter. But first, Doctor, I've got a very, very sick woman on my hands. She seems to have been bitten. I don't recognize the bite. Whatever it is, it's incredibly toxic.
Toxic? And is it a ragged wound? Heterodont bite pattern, about 20 centimeters across the jaw?
That sounds about right.
What about her eyes? Discolored sclera, opsoclonus?
Yes, exactly. That's exactly what I'm seeing.
Damn it. You don't have much time. She's gonna go into a series of convulsions and she won't come back. Do you have any carfentanil?
No, I don't, Doctor.
You need a powerful tranquilizer to counter the toxins. You need it quick.
All right.
If you want
all right, okay, maybe in the lab. No, no, wait, the trank darts for the rifle. That's in a torphine blend.
That could work. Get that into her as quick as you can. In the meantime, stay with her. When the shaking starts, you need to hold her steady.
But isn't that dangerous? I mean, normally if someone's having a seizure...
Please, just follow my instructions. Her life depends on it. Call me on this channel after you've given her the tranquilizer.
Will do. I need to move that woman so I can work on her, and I'm gonna need...
Tranquilizer darts. Yeah, I heard. They're in the car. I'll get them.
Okay, but listen to me. If you hear anything, see anything, don't take any risks. You just come straight back here.
Don't worry. I'm on it.
Jess, get out now!
What?
Jess, don't move! It can only see you when you're moving! Just stay out of sight!
mind darts.
Dad, I can get the darts.
No, Jess. Just get out of here.
I'm not leaving you.
You're not going to last much longer, are you?
Listen to me. There's only one way to do this. I'm gonna count to three, and you're gonna let go. And I'm gonna be right here. I'm gonna catch you, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Good. One.
Found you last night. We almost like ran into you. So who is Mariquita?
Mariquita? It's nobody. A word.
Oh, my Spanish is so lame. I was trying to talk to you in the car, and it's like I thought you were gonna kill me because my grammar sucks.
So what did we talk about?
Help's on the way. The control room is a mess, but the phones are working.
Hey, you look a whole lot better. Ingen is sending a rescue team. A helicopter will be here soon to take us to the mainland.
A rescue team? Ingen. My things. I had a pack.
Oh, it's right here.
That bite on your arm. What happened?
Something in the jungle. You know what? I don't have time for this.
Whoa, take it easy. Take it easy. Don't push yourself.
There won't be any rescue. Not for you.
Hey, Yoder! Looks like the storm really tore this place up.
Yeah, it ain't the storm we're here to rescue people from, Decaf.
Yeah, I heard. So who did get left behind on Dino Island?
Biogeneticist Dr. Laura Sorkin. Genetic engineer David Banks. Park veterinarian Jerry Harding. and his daughter Jessica Harding, also an unidentified woman in need of medevac.
Did you mention a daughter?
Yeah, I guess it was feed your daughter to work day or something.
Bravo team, this is Alpha Dog. What's your ETA on the visitor center? Over.
We're here, where are you? This place is a disaster area. There's no sign of the survivors. Over.
Just finishing our sweep. Heading to the LZ now.
Go, go, go!
Damn, Linares. What were you shooting at? Oscar, it's Garza. Decaf, keep the engine running. Be ready to get us out of here.
Roger.
Billy, get up here.
I don't know what...
Shh. Get away from me, damn it! Get away!
What the hell?
Vargas.
Decaf, we're going in. Watch your ass out there.
Trust no one.
What the hell happened to you guys?
It's not my fault. We couldn't see them. Only their eyes.
Come on out now, Vargas.
What the hell?
Yoda, get back! I got this.
I'll see if there's another way around.
Quit screwing around, Vargas.
Get out of the light! They'll see you!
An order.
We're sitting ducks here on the beach. We've got to find shelter.
What do you think you're doing, Vargas?
I found some security monitors.
Talk to me, Yoder. Where is he?
I can't see Vargas. It's too dark.
Where are you? In the trees? Show yourself!
What the hell? Yoder, I'm blind out here. Check the monitors. Can you see anything?
Right side, behind the rock thing.
Oh, nice shot.
Where's my gun? We're under attack. They'll be back. Who are you? Get away from me.
Holy... What the hell happened to him? Hey, hey, Vargas, look at me!
They're everywhere, even now, watching us. We gotta!
Oscar, we gotta find out what happened to Vargas. Get him some help.
Forget it. He's lost it.
Security office. Maybe there's something on the tapes. Hang in there, Vargas. Hey, there's another security monitor over there. See if you can find anything on the videotapes.
We should go.
Ah, we can't just leave him like that, man. If we can find out what happened, maybe we can help him. There, see? What is that?
Don't know. Take a look at this.
Who the hell is that?
I'm guessing those are the Hardings. So that woman just ran off with our paycheck. We gotta go.
Decaf, get that engine started. We're lifting off.
You have to take us back to the visitor center. You have no idea what you're getting into out here.
I know my way. I just need you to keep us safe from these creatures.
Oh, really? How am I supposed to do that? Electric fences are down, dinosaurs have free run of the island. None of us are safe here.
This is InGen Rescue Team Alpha trying to reach Dr. Jerry Harding. If you're still out there, we're trying to...
Maybe we should try to leave a trail for them or something.
Jess, that's enough. If we want to keep out of the way of dangerous predators, I'm gonna need to know where we're headed.
Norte.
North? To the coast, what for?
Don't worry about it.
Ugh. You're hurt. Let me help you.
Yeah, help me! We're going to rest here for a minute.
If we're stopping, I'll need to make a fire. It'll keep the dinosaurs away.
Fine. Stay where I can see you. Siéntate.
Is there anything I can do?
Stay close.
Dad? There are some fresh dino tracks here. They're small, like a chicken's.
Don't wander off.
It's likely Compsognathus. I saw lots of them while we were walking. It's relatively harmless. It's nothing to worry about.
There are some eggs over here. Any chance they could be dino eggs?
Eggs? No. Remember, all the dinosaurs on the island are female? Still, just leave them alone. We have enough problems without an angry mama bird or lizard to deal with. Do you have any family?
None of your business.
I just thought that if you could understand how...
You love your daughter, don't you?
Yes, of course.
You'd do anything to make sure she grows up safe.
Yeah, I would.
Then I know you'll do exactly as I say. And as long as you do that, I won't shoot her.
You have a daughter, don't you?
Stop talking.
Think of her. And you'll understand what I'm...
I said shut up!
I'm sorry.
You know nothing about me. We are not simpatico, comprende?
Okay, I'm sorry. I won't mention it again. Please.
Hey, I drank like 4 diet sodas earlier, and I really have to pee, like, super bad.
Go. Hurry.
Hello? Can anyone hear me?
Please identify yourself. Over.
Hey, hi. This is Jessica Harding. Me and my dad were supposed to have been rescued, but there's this woman with a gun. I think she's taking us up north.
Okay, can you describe your location? Any buildings, roads, landmarks?
No, not really. Just regular jungle crap, like trees and dirt and stuff. Everything looks the same out here. Oh, but my dad built a fire? You might be able to see the smoke if...
Yo!
Oh! What happened? Is that them? Is that the Hardings?
Yeah, it was the girl. It didn't sound good down there. Girls said they were headed north. Let's head that way and see what we can find.
Hang on to your butt.
Estúpido!
Please, this is my fault.
I don't want to kill you, but I will do it in a heartbeat if I have to, comprende? What I have to lose is too important. Let's go. We're getting out of here.
See anything, Oscar?
Looks familiar.
How's that exactly?
Smoke.
Smoke? Think they're trying to signal us?
I thought we were dealing with a hostage situation.
Oh, I don't believe that! That'll do it for our flight.
Oh, man. InGen's gonna be pissed when they get the bill for this.
Yeah, then they should have gotten pterodactyl insurance.
Pteranodon insurance.
Huh?
Can you fix it?
Yeah. Give me about a month.
You've got an hour. These jungles seem different.
Different from what? All jungles kind of look the same to me.
I smell smoke.
Check it out. They're close. Come on.
Hold up. It may not be safe.
I know. That's what I have this for.
You realize we're headed straight towards a cliff? There's no way down from here. We're gonna have to find another way around, which will take us, I don't know, at least a half a day.
There's an old goat path that will take us down. What the?
Oh, wow. How can you tell me about any rides like this?
None of the rides are ready for the public. I didn't want to get your hopes up.
That path was ancient, carved into the stone. It survived storms, earthquakes.
Look, it's too late to go around, and it's too dangerous to go back the way we came. Just use the radio. Contact the rescue team. It is our best chance of survival.
Down there. We can ride this contraption to get us down to that exit.
Obviously not ready for people to use.
Well, it looks like the only way. Get the power on.
We're still going?
Yeah, it's getting dark. We cannot go back the way we came.
What's that?
It sounds like the dinosaurs are getting ready to hunt.
Are they hunting us?
They're still a good ways off, but we shouldn't stick around here for long.
Oscar, definitely signs of camp. The subjects were here. We got some fresh tracks here, Oscar. I'm guessing dinos.
Come on back.
Jess, be careful.
Looks like we have power.
Well, that ought to do it. Since the ride is in maintenance mode, it should be safe. It won't go very fast.
Come on. The sooner we get to the coast, the sooner this will all be over.
Hang on. This is gonna be a short trip.
Can this thing go any faster? Dad? Ay, Dios mío! What are those things?
We need to switch the track! Here it comes. Yes! Get away from her!
Dad, are you okay?
I'm okay, honey. Just stay down. Oh, no. There's more.
I want to get off! I want to get off! Jerry, move!
Thank you.
You.
What now?
Now, we go for a little ride. So what did you call those things that were chasing you?
Herrerasaurus from the Triassic era.
Where's Denny?
Decaf! You take the chopper. I'll check the perimeter. Stay put.
HU-121, eh? I haven't seen one of these in a while. Boy. Your pilot's a real slob.
Keep your mouth shut. Don't even think about it. Danny's, and it's jammed.
Oscar! I don't like what's going on here, man. Decaf's gun's jammed, there's a blood trail over there, and he never leaves his helmet on the ground. Never!
Decaf is MIA.
MIA. MIA? No way, man. He was supposed to stay with the chopper. He's gotta be around here somewhere.
Billy, you feel that?
We've already lost Bravo team, and
Billy!
We are not leaving without Decaf. I mean, we agreed, right? I will not let you turn this into Nicaragua all over again.
At ease! We've got a situation here. Inside the chopper.
Woo! We got power!
You're a good little thief. You know how to open handcuffs?
So who's left?
Dr. Sorkin and her assistant!
What about Decaf?
Decaf's dead.
I like your tattoos.
The gravestones are for the people who died beside him. The skulls are for the people who died because of him. Tell us, where are you gonna put Decaf's tombstone? You're running out of room.
What did you say?
Hey, come on. It's been a long day and everyone's just a little tense. Let's keep it together, guys.
Don't be fooled. You're in the company of killers. You're no safer than you were in the jungle. You need further proof that these men are crazy? This is what they do. They hurt people, and then they joke about it. This is how men act when they lack the courage to face themselves.
Enough!
What are you gonna do, kill me? You did that to me once already.
You're crazy!
I'm thinking of getting a butterfly tattoo. On my
ankle. I'm gonna carve the names of the people you killed into those skulls of yours.
Quiet.
Then we'll see how proud you
listen,
are of them.
Listen, there's still more people who need our help. Whatever your issues are, you can work them out when we get to the mainland.
And no, you cannot get a tattoo.
Dr. Harding.
Oh, thank goodness you're safe. After we lost contact, I was worried something had happened to you.
We have had quite a day, Dr. Sorkin.
I'll bet. Systems are down all over the damn park. Dinosaurs are running free. What's going on here?
There were some complications.
Who are you?
I'm Billy Yoder, and this is...
Look, let's just get this out of the way. I'm not going anywhere. This part of the island is pretty remote and is a long way from the predators. I'm perfectly safe, and I don't need saving.
That's not a good idea, ma'am.
But, since you're here, what you can do is start loading the stacks of bureaucratic InGen paperwork that's taking up valuable space. They were supposed to have sent for that stuff months ago.
Listen, lady, we don't have time for this. You either get in the helicopter peacefully, or I will personally knock you out, put you in cuffs, and throw you in!
You lay one hand on me, and I will have you so ass deep in litigation that you'll be reading legal text for a decade.
Yeah, you know what? If it'll help us get off this island faster, we'll move your boxes. Where are they?
Over there, at the loading dock.
You heard the lady.
Hey, can I help?
Sure, why the hell not?
Well, geez, don't be so excited about it.
Yeah, you're right. This is a big deal. I should be throwing a box-moving party.
Thanks for coming to rescue us.
It's what I do.
That and moving people's stuff around.
I could use a few good marks in my employee file. It's been a rough year.
I know, right? I almost got suspended for skipping class too much. Mom would have killed me.
Well, we all got problems.
So what's the deal? Why didn't you tell Dr. Sorkin why it's so important to get off this island?
Trust me, if we bully that one, she's gonna cause problems.
Hey, can I bum one of those? Okay.
I'm not moving these things. They look like they weigh a ton.
So what do we do?
Simple. Charm her.
I mean, I knew Hammond was no real scientist, but someone should have seen this coming.
So how did you know to treat her with a tranquilizer?
Unfortunately, this isn't the first time I've encountered this. The toxins are derived from the bacteria in its bite, like the Komodo dragon.
Well, what kind of dinosaur has a bite like that?
I saw some bites like that on one of my men back at the visitor center.
Mr. Yoder, would you please tend to the InGen files like we discussed?
Yes, ma'am. Was there any dirt on Dr. Sorkin in the mission briefing?
Big-time protester in the 70s, lots of animal rights crap. Handful of arrests for it. All of her InGen-related history is classified. Said to expect her to be a pain in the ass.
It said that?
Between the lines.
Looks like Dr. Sorkin wanted to turn this place into a dinosaur preserve instead of an amusement park.
And InGen didn't go for it, huh?
Why would they? There's no money in that.
You know, he actually told me it doesn't matter that we have dinosaurs from the Jurassic and Triassic ages living together, as long as it's exciting, moron.
I wonder what the outside world's gonna think of all this. The government of Costa Rica will certainly have to think twice about InGen's presence here.
If you're assuming the outside world will ever hear of it, the confidentiality agreements we signed are ironclad, and InGen's lawyers can be awfully intimidating. Trust me, I know.
I hate to interrupt, ma'am, but I really think we need to be going.
I'm afraid I can't, Mr. Yoder. Someone needs to tend to the dinosaurs during this disaster.
I'm sorry, Dr. Sorkin, but InGen wants all survivors back on the mainland as soon as possible. No exceptions.
Why can't it wait?
Hammond really made a mess of this place. You have no idea. There's no hiding his incompetence after this disaster.
You have a point.
Someone needs to speak to the board about protecting these dinosaurs. You believe in animal rights, don't you? Wouldn't you put your neck on the line for them?
If only the board had listened to my proposals. Instead, they just contribute to the paperwork in the file boxes you guys are loading.
It's kind of stupid to treat these creatures like they're in some kind of circus, right?
You're absolutely right, Mr. Yoder. But none of this matters if the board of directors...
I'm not supposed to say this, but I heard the board is going to hold an emergency meeting about, you know, new leadership. If you were there, you could act as a witness to the events that took place here. They'd have to listen to you.
That's true. I hate to admit it, Mr. Yoder, but perhaps you're right.
And our orders also mention an assistant?
David. Yes. I'm afraid David won't be coming back with us. He told him to stay away from the quarantine.
Oh, Dr. Sorkin, I'm so sorry.
Thank you. Now, before we go, I have some work in the lab that must be completed first. Dr. Harding, perhaps you and your daughter would like to assist me. I've been working on a cure for one of our dinosaurs' nastier genetic disorders.
Oh? Which one?
It's dietary. Right up your alley. Dr. Harding, we've done it.
What exactly have we done?
Reverse the lysine contingency, of course.
Wait, what?
What's that?
InGen, Henry Wu, added a gene to the dinosaurs that makes them dependent on supplements of an amino acid called lysine. Without their weekly doses, they'll all die off.
You cannot give that to the dinosaurs. They need to be contained. If any of them get off the island...
Okay, listen. I've been working with the Parasaur's behavioral program for months now. If I go back to the mainland to fight for this place, they'll all be dead before I can get back, along with all of my research.
Parasaurs?
Parasaurolophus. They're herbivores, generally say. How many are we talking about?
Why don't you come out with me? See how much progress we've made with them.
Henry, Dad?
Fine. We'll go.
I'm glad to finally have you out here, Dr. Harding, despite the circumstances. We've been doing some very interesting work with our parasaurs. Behavioral communication experiments.
You've interpreted their calls?
Some of them. And I plan to use that to get them out of the pen.
Out?
Well, I'm not going to treat their water with them still in there.
How do we know there aren't any bad dinosaurs around?
See that one? She's the lookout. She'll stand guard while the others graze. If there were any predators in the vicinity, she'd be nervous and emitting a danger call. But she's not. She's calm. Jerry, you can activate the speakers from there.
Dad, it's okay.
Stay with Dr. Sorkin.
So I heard you were like a hippie protester or something in the 70s.
Where'd you hear that?
From Yoder.
The 70s were a tumultuous time. I fought for what I believed in, and sometimes it gets you arrested.
You were arrested? And you still got a job as a, you know, scientist?
Paleogeneticist. And yes, youth is the time to be reckless and test your boundaries. It's how you learn what's important to you.
So, what happened to your assistant?
He was a wonderful young man. And I am sad. I really am. But if I let that stop my work, then all these animals will die too, trapped behind the walls that we built.
That's it. They're out. Go forth and multiply.
This is why she was elected to be the lookout. What's wrong with her foot?
It's a broken toe. Feel free to have a look. I just have to do one more thing, and then we can leave.
Lysine.
If the dinosaurs are to have a fighting chance, they'll need the solution to survive.
I'm still not sure.
Jerry, this is my life's work. These are basically my children. I'm not gonna let these creatures die because some bureaucrat can't stand losing control. They deserve their own lives.
Don't tell my dad, but I got a D in chemistry.
Then today should be very educational. The solution we were creating at the lab will reverse this scenario, allowing the animals to live out their natural lifespan. We just need to get it into the main water supply.
Okay, that should be easy, right?
This is a big responsibility, Jess.
I can handle it, Dr. Sorkin.
Okay, Jess, let's get started.
You hear that?
Go, go, go!
Oscar! I'll pull you in!
Tell that woman she's dead when I get in there!
Hey! What the hell?
Stand this thing! Now!
No. Not so good.
Is the water ready?
Yep.
Excellent. Now I just need to get this water into the main supply and we'll be done. That's it, Jess. We did it. Jess, come up here. I want you to see this. This is how nature intended these animals to exist.
Wow. With all the running away I've been doing, I haven't had time to really appreciate them.
Oh, girl, take it easy.
What's wrong with that one?
Oh, no.
Raptors.
Dad!
Jerry, run!
Behind you! Oh. Damn, no!
Yeah, I'm fine.
Those are velociraptors.
Where did they come from? What are they doing out here?
Must have escaped from the quarantine pen somehow.
Raptors are highly intelligent. They'll find a way up here if we give them enough time.
Yes! It's Yoder!
Here! We're down here!
Down here! Down here!
Stop stopping! Trying to bring the tower down.
It'll hold. It's got to.
Yeah, well, I don't want to take any chances. We're lucky that chopper didn't kill us all.
I don't feel so lucky.
The emergency ladder's right there. The way the tower is tilting, it will put us down outside the paddock.
Well, that's a start, but the fence isn't much of an obstacle for the raptors. Where do we go once we're out?
I think we can make it to the utility tunnels, right over there. We can lock the raptors out if we can beat them inside.
I hope you're right. Won't budge.
Maybe if you put more weight on it?
What, you mean stand on it?
Yes, ride it down.
Okay, but we should probably be ready to move as soon as it comes down so we can stick together. No, Jess!
I'm fine, Dad!
Your turn, Dr. Sorkin.
Right, I'm coming down.
I'm moving!
Out of the way, I'm gonna jump for it! I'm okay.
Run, Dr. Sorkin! Jump, Billy!
Next time I get a headache like this, there better be tequila involved.
No way, amigo. This turned out better than the last time you drank tequila.
Yeah, you might be right. The girl I woke up next to is prettier, anyway. How'd she make it out?
Butt first. I gave her a push.
I'm surprised you'd take the time to rescue her, what with how nice she was to you and all. We lost our ride, and the only person we managed to rescue so far doesn't even work for InGen. Now what?
Make sure the girl's okay while I scout the perimeter.
Ah, damn it, I left my AK inside the chopper. It's probably toast. Glad I didn't leave a round chambered. Could have killed someone.
That makes two of us, amigo. Still, the cook-off was a hell of a show.
Wow, Barbasol. Heavier than I remember. Could just be full, I guess.
T-Rex, it's leaving.
Damn it, Oscar. I only have one pair of pants. The chopper's not gonna blow, but just about everything in it, including our weapons, is flame broiled.
No game trails, no nests. This is base camp for now. I'm gonna go look for our friends.
Shouldn't I come with?
We lost the guns. Means I gotta be in stealth mode.
You saying I can't sneak?
I'm saying neither one of us can sneak and watch her at the same time.
Any idea where we are in relation to the rest of the park?
We're not far from the marine exhibit. I know for a fact that the phone there is in working order, or at least it was this morning.
Can we get there from the tunnels?
I believe so.
All right then, lead the way. Want to get us out of here as soon as possible. No more science projects, okay?
I understand.
Dios mío, they open doors.
So, Laura, why don't you do your radio show anymore?
Well, it wasn't really radio. I'd hack into the park intercom and play choice cuts from my record collection. Lately, I haven't had the time.
Did you really have to show Artie Bridges how to do it?
Believe me, I regret it. But how was I to know how bad he was? He begged me, said it was his dream to be in radio.
You know what? He should stick to managing the janitorial group. He is awful.
He certainly is. I guess there was a reason it was just a dream. He actually records his show ahead of time so that he can broadcast during work hours.
Did you guys hear that?
Sounded like a rat.
Mm-hmm. Dinosaurs aren't the only invasive species InGen brought to the island. There are lots of rats in these tunnels. Maintenance is always setting traps down here.
How is it that Dr. Wu became chief geneticist over you?
That's an easy one. Frogs.
You're saying frogs kept you from getting promoted?
Specifically, their DNA. Before we could clone any dinosaurs, we had to decide how to fill in the gaps in the DNA sequences we found.
I remember this from the tour. You found dino blood inside mosquito fossils.
That's right. I wanted a complete prehistoric genome, cross-referencing all of the DNA found in the various amber samples. It would have been safer, but would have taken time the board of directors didn't want to spend.
Well, even Dr. Hammond's spare-no-expense philosophy has limits, I guess.
Exactly. Henry, Dr. Wu, proposed using frog DNA to fill in the gaps. It was risky. We still don't know all of the effects. But it was a solution, and a fast one at that. So Henry became chief geneticist, and I took to the field.
You sure we shouldn't head to the visitor center, Dr. Sorkin? InGen is bound to start there when they don't hear from the rescue team.
These tunnels don't run all the way to the visitor center, and I don't know about you, but I'd rather not risk any more overland travel.
Good point.
Ay, Dios mío. How am I not dead? They left me alone. Idiotas. At least one of them pulled me out of there. Not sure I'd do the same.
Where's the cane?
Nieta, no, no, no!
Looking for this?
That's mine!
You know, this takes me back. I learned to shave with this stuff.
Give it back! Now!
I'm all out of shaving cream myself. You mind if I borrow some?
Stop shaking it!
But you're supposed to shake it before you use it. Says so right on the can. You want to tell me what's so important about shaving cream?
It was my lover's. He died fighting for the revolution in Chile. It's all I have of his. Please give it back.
Oh, that is so sweet. You want to try again?
Embryos. They're dinosaur embryos. If you drop them, they'll be destroyed. Maybe we can make a deal.
This ought to be good.
There's a lot of money in it for you if I get those embryos to my contact before they go bad. You turn that over to InGen. You get a pat on the back. Maybe a little Christmas bonus. You leave it to me, you become a rich man. Pay off your debts, quit your job. No more guys in suits telling you what to do. Just think about it.
Keep talking.
I have a daughter. I need the money to get her out of the ghetto. You know what happens to girls there. She doesn't deserve that life.
Are you for real?
Come on, Billy. The money's good. And you'll be helping me save my daughter. Everybody gets a little something.
Okay, here's the deal. One, I'm in charge. I keep the embryos. And as soon as it's safe to break away, we'll deliver them to your contact.
I don't know if the embryos will last in there much longer.
That's a risk we're gonna take. Two, we're cutting Oscar in.
Why?
Because he's my partner, that's why. Now sit tight and lighten up.
Has anyone seen my cigarettes? I could swear I had some.
I didn't realize you smoked.
Normally I manage to duck out a few times a day, but we've been preoccupied.
Where did you last have them?
Right here in my pocket, or so I thought.
Maybe they fell out when we jumped from the water tower?
I suppose. Oh well, I'm probably better off without them.
Do you mind if we stop for a rest? My legs are killing me.
I suppose we could all use a break.
I don't know how much longer those embryos will last. We need to meet my contact at the boat.
We're staying here until Oscar gets back.
We don't even know if he's alive.
He's coming back, and come hell or high water, we are not leaving.
Come on, we gotta run!
No time, hide! Get out of here, guys. Out of here.
Care for a lysine supplement?
No, thanks. Well, you know what? Maybe I will. All this running around, my muscles probably need whatever protein I can give them.
My thoughts exactly. I haven't gotten this much exercise since Carnival.
I guess we've got a lot of extra lysine now that the parasaurs don't need the external supply.
Yeah, about that. It's not just the parasaurs. We added the antidote to the main water supply.
But that'll reach every dinosaur in the park. You're insane! Denying the dinosaurs lysine was the only safety mechanism we had to keep them out of the global ecosystem!
The biosphere is resilient enough to handle one generation of dinosaurs, even if there's a recovery period.
A recovery period?
These animals are now part of the global ecosystem, whether we like it or not. We can't expect them to exist outside of it.
There's not an environment on Earth, including this one, that can maintain equilibrium with these animals around. Invasive species. It doesn't even begin to describe the problem.
We've already denied them the right to breed. That's their death sentence.
Yes, but who knows how much damage they can do before then? A single brachiosaur can destroy as much jungle in one day as a whole herd of elephants. I can imagine the impact a group of them would have on a rainforest.
Do I need to remind you that there are 120 miles of ocean between Isla Nublar and the mainland? The lysine contingency was cruel and unnecessary.
It was a prerequisite to working here.
For you, maybe. But you have to remember, Jerry, Henry Wu came up with the lysine contingency. And let's not mince words, it's a kill switch. As part of his bid for the top spot. I couldn't stop it, but I never agreed to it.
You're still here.
Let's see. Continue my life's work, or let other people corrupt it, profit by it, and completely prevent me from even talking about it. Does that sound like a choice to you?
No, I guess not.
No matter the circumstance, you can't possibly believe it's okay to eradicate an entire species, let alone whole groups of them, regardless of how they came to be here. No one has that right.
But surely you recognize that this is a special case. We are responsible.
We are responsible, not just for our own welfare, but for the animals as well.
Do you know for a fact that none of these animals can swim?
Oh, come on, Jerry.
It's how Asian elephants migrated to Sri Lanka from India. There's precedent.
You're being ridiculous. There's no evidence sauropods were swimmers. None. You see them in the field every day. Have you ever even seen one of our dinosaurs try to swim?
We keep them in cages, Laura. They don't get the chance. I know this. More quadrupeds can swim than can't.
All right. I'll concede that it's possible there are sauropods that can swim. But I still believe that 120 miles of open water is an effective barrier. The remote possibility that a dinosaur could make it to the mainland is far outweighed by our responsibility to treat these animals humanely. They're here because of us.
I don't know, Laura. I don't know. I need to process this. I'm gonna have to tell InGen.
Are you guys done yet?
Jess, where'd you go?
Just down the hall looking at stuff. Not that you noticed, I was gone.
I'm sorry, honey. I was distracted. But don't go off again like that, okay?
Yeah, okay.
No good. Here it comes. Go!
Chase him!
Come on, nice tasty dinosaur.
Yeah.
Do these things ever stop eating?
Damn, you're lucky. You ought to forget our deal and buy a lottery ticket.
The embryos.
Yeah, relax.
You lost it. You lost it?
It must have fallen out.
Do you know what you've done?
In case you didn't notice, it wasn't exactly a leisurely stroll over here.
You dropped it. You find it.
Hold your horses. That T-Rex is still out there.
Payout that you let fall out of your pocket.
Sorry, I guess I was a little preoccupied with a giant, prehistoric people-eater breathing down my neck.
So we know where it is. Go get it!
Yeah, I think I'll wait until our friend there leaves to find a new chew toy.
I don't know if we have time. If the embryos go bad, they're worthless!
The embryos are worthless to me if I get eaten by a damn lizard.
I'll do it myself.
Hang on. The deal is I hold on to the embryos until we reach your contact.
I know! And instead, you drop them!
Yeah, well... crap.
Just go and hurry. Makes up for dropping it in the first place.
Probably a rat or something. Keep moving.
No, I saw eyes just like that before I was beaten. I won't go through that again.
Big, shiny eyes?
You saw them too?
Not here, but yeah. Come on, we gotta keep moving.
No way! Not until I can see where I'm going.
Okay. We can't go back outside because of our old friend Rexy, but maybe we can get the lights on. It seems like those things, whatever they are, like to stick to the shadows.
What's the holdup?
It's nothing. It's just a different, model than I'm used to.
Why don't you just read the instructions? They're right there, no?
Relax. This thing is just a glorified fuse box.
What about that thing there? Maybe you have to prime it before turning it on, like an oil pump or something.
Push to close. I got it now. Close your eyes. You're about to lose your... night vision.
What's going on? Dad?
Over here, Jess. It's all right. The backup generator wasn't meant to last this long, that's all.
No, that's not it. We should have been fine for days.
How the hell was I supposed to know open meant turn everything off? I mean, it's counterintuitive.
You would know if you read the instructions.
Why don't you yell a little louder? I think there's a dinosaur on the other side of the island that didn't hear you.
Whatever. There's a close, right?
Yeah, I'll close that crap right up. Yeah, that's right. Who's your... Oh, come on!
Rocking Jurassic Park's only unofficial radio station. Just a reminder before we sign off, Parklings. If you're not on the boat by 7, you're not going to be on the boat at all. I've got a little something special for all you last-minute packers out there. Personal favorite of mine, and I'll see you all on board.
Damn it, Artie.
He's not still here.
No. From the sound of it, he queued up this last bit of tape and took off. This show is over.
Holy crap, Oscar. Did you just take one of those things out by hand?
You're supposed to be at the crash site.
Yeah, the plan didn't factor in an angry T-Rex, so we had to change it. I didn't think to engage it in a knife fight, sorry.
We?
That's right. Turns out little Miss Sunshine here is smuggling dino embryos off the island.
You don't have the skills to pull off a heist like that.
They're real. My client had someone on the inside, a man named Nedry. He didn't show, so they sent me to find the embryos. On the backup plan.
Well?
Squares with what I know. They're searching San Jose for this Nedry guy.
They can stop the search. He's dino food.
You have a plan.
Yeah, well, turns out these things are worth a lot of money. I'm not doing anything unless you're down. But come on, Oscar. Do you really think InGen gives a rat's ass about us? Look what happened to B-Team, to Decaf. Their families are gonna get a puny check, a gag order, and nothing else.
There's no time to save these people and be her errand boys before this place turns to ground zero.
What do you mean, ground zero?
Nothing. We could do it, Oscar. We've got a call for another helicopter anyway, so one of us takes the eggheads back to the mainland and the other takes her to meet her contact.
Let me guess. That last part would be up to you.
You just tell InGen that I bought it like the rest of the guys they sent. Then you and I hook up later to split our cut.
I trust you, but I don't trust her. InGen throws a lot of work our way. Not sure I want to burn that bridge.
I understand, but we're talking about a retirement level payout here. Look, you don't have to decide now. Plenty of time before we call for another chopper.
All right, let's move out. Take it slow and quiet.
I respect your opinion, Jerry. Although, to be honest, I'm a little surprised at your lack of regard for the animals.
It's not that I don't care about them, Laura. It's just there are so many unintended consequences that come with your decision. We can't keep this a secret, Laura.
Shoot.
We need contingency plans. We'll need to monitor things outside of the park.
Where is it? I know it. Yes.
What's wrong?
What happened?
Jerry!
I can't keep this up for long! This way! Come on, stay with me! You sure you want to take care of business? Your last friend wasn't so lucky!
What the?
Amazing.
That was awesome!
No problem.
Okay, hon. Let the man breathe.
Yoder! You're alive!
We're alive? I'm surprised you guys lasted 5 minutes without me and Oscar.
Thank you.
Forget it.
Oh my god, you're bleeding! Are you okay?
No worries. Belongs to one of them.
That's so badass.
Well, hey, I outran a T-Rex.
It's nothing.
Are you gonna get a tattoo of a raptor now?
Not a bad idea.
You aren't fooling me.
What now?
You can pretend to be a hero all you want, but we both know what you really are.
Everyone, we have a problem.
I don't think steam can, you know, eat us or anything.
You've seen the flickering lights, now the steam eruptions. Something's gone wrong with the island's geothermal power plant.
That's not our problem.
When the power plant explodes, it will be.
It's that bad?
Everything I've read about the system says it's supposed to shut itself down if something goes wrong with the steam pressure. The fact that it hasn't means that the pressure will build unchecked. It'll pop like a balloon and take half the island with it.
Are you sure the power plant is the problem?
It's the steam that clinches it for me, Jerry. The power could fail for a lot of reasons, but the steam comes straight from the power plant.
Spare no expense didn't apply to the island's largest potential safety risk.
The plan itself was well designed. It's the procedure that's flawed. As I recall, only 2 or 3 people on the island were trained to safely operate the main power controls.
Hey, about before, the hostage thing? I'm sorry. I was only trying to protect myself. Me and the mercs, we worked it out.
Worked it out? How?
Don't worry about it.
So, turning the power off and on requires special training?
It's down this way. We really ought to get moving.
How about a smoke?
I wish. I swore I had some on me, but... Jess? Something to share?
I'm sorry. I just wanted to borrow them. But then a dinosaur was there, and I threw them, and I think it ate them.
You let the raptors get to us because you wanted to smoke?
Mom smokes. You did too, when I was younger.
That's not the point. It's not just the smoking, it's stealing. It's not listening. Remember, the main reason you're on this island is because your mother thinks I might be able to straighten you out. Somehow.
Right. Not because you want to see me or anything. Look, you don't have to worry about me, Dad. I'm almost 15. I can take care of myself.
Oh, honey, I know it feels like that. Especially at your age, but you're not an adult. You might be a young woman, physically, but emotional maturity takes time.
Okay? I'm sorry, Dad, but how many times have you been married? Your kids? Have you even talked to Sarah lately? This year, even? Should you be lecturing anyone about emotional maturity?
Plant's gonna blow, right? We ain't got time for this after-school special crap.
Okay, listen up. We need to release the steam pressure to prevent any more buildup. I think that's the pressure release we're looking for.
I'll handle it.
Looks like we pressed open the circuit in order to turn the power off. Here goes nothing.
Press to open, that does make sense.
It does now.
Could you guys give me a hand with this valve? It won't budge.
One.
You,
two,
need any help?
Three. I'm quite capable, thank you. Four.
Is that the...
It's the press to close light. It means the charge is pumped.
Nora?
It's all right, everyone. It's just a fail-safe measure to protect the plant. Everything is just fine.
If you say so.
The door controls! They're completely fried!
Thank you.
Can these doors be open manually?
I'm afraid not. The only way we can get them open is by using the controls by the doors where we came in.
I'm on it.
No! No way! That's suicide!
He's right. The raptors wouldn't have come back if they were still afraid of you.
I'll just have to give them a new reason to be scared, then.
Can we at least talk about this?
Look, Billy, we gotta get these people out of here. I figure they got no chance with both of us gone. I could get down that way.
Don't go! You could die!
Don't count me out yet. Give me a diversion, will ya? Couple of seconds at least!
Hey. Thanks.
I hope he makes it back.
Try not to worry. The man has skills.
I thought you hated him.
But I respect his ability. If anyone can do this, he can.
Hey, check this out, huh? Nice, tasty drumstick! Too slow, you dumb lizard!
Actually...
your buddy had?
Run, Oscar! Come on, Oscar, get up! Get up!
Nothing you can do. Sorry for your loss, but we have to get out of here.
There.
That was their fear response. Something about this place scares them.
Are you okay, Billy?
What the hell do you think?
What Oscar did was very brave. When we get back, we're gonna make sure he is duly recognized for his...
You think I care about that crap? I know what you people think of us. Bunch of blue-collar grunts, right? Bunch of high school dropouts. We're replaceable.
We don't think that!
Oscar was worth 1,000 of you, but he knew it! And he still died to save your ass! So don't tell me how you're gonna honor him! You don't deserve
to! Okay, what can we do?
Nothing! All I need is space!
Whatever spooked those raptors might be nearby.
What is that? It smells like the jungle. Only more rotten.
What the hell's going on over there?
Come with me, Jess. Try not to look, okay?
This guy's dressed a lot like you, Billy.
Does he have a tattoo on his arm? Like mine?
Yes, yes, he does.
Laura.
Eggs. It is a nest. I thought the structure looked like the nest of a cassowary, maybe an emu, but without eggs, I couldn't be sure.
Yes, but they're inside him.
If you'd asked me 5 minutes ago, I'd have told you such behavior didn't exist outside of class Insecta, but
now... He's a human being!
I'm sorry. You're absolutely right.
My God, he's alive!
His pulse is faint, but it's there. Look for bite marks.
Bite marks? Yes, yes, they look just like...
Just like the ones Nima had, I know. He's alive, but only technically. He's paralyzed and almost certainly brain dead. This is the Venom's final stage.
Is he alive or not?
He's alive, but in a comatose state. Something has laid eggs in his abdomen.
Something what?
The victim is being kept alive by
Decaf!
I'm sorry?
The victim is Daniel Cafaro, another throwaway grunt.
Oh my God. I knew they'd gotten out somehow, but I never thought...
Knew about this? You knew? I'll kill you!
What are you doing?
Tell us, Doctor. What's out there? What did this to him?
They're called Trodon Pectinodon. They were meant to be euthanized. I thought they may have been leaving the pen somehow.
Knew about those damn creatures all along. While we were out there, exposed, humping around like idiots looking for our pilot,
Billy.
We were nearly killed by one of our own men. Probably bitten by one of those things, just like Decaf. Who knows where his catatonic body is now? Both our teams are dead. Oscar is dead. All because of your dinosaurs, all because of you.
You can't make her pay for all that Injun has done.
Maybe.
Put down the knife. We need to work together, all of us.
All she has to say is, it's my fault. It's my fault. Come on, Doc, let me hear it.
No, it wasn't.
Say it!
It's my fault.
There. That wasn't so difficult, was it? Your friends may have saved you here, but at least I got the truth out of you. You want her alive? You got her. You just mark my words. She will save just one of those animals before she lifts a finger to help you. Now, everyone make themselves useful. I've got to tend to Decaf.
I don't understand. I thought the dinosaurs couldn't breed.
They can't. They're all female.
Then how do they lay eggs?
Theropods shed eggs just like most other egg-laying animals. Think about chickens. The whole egg market is made up of unfertilized eggs, right?
Oh, yeah. So they still have to lay them?
Oh, my.
What is it?
You bring up a good point about our dinosaurs ovulating, but these eggs are gathered in a clutch. This is brooding behavior.
So, chickens will brood a large enough clutch?
But not our dinosaurs. I've found post-ovulatory eggs in the ranges. They're mal-shaped, usually destroyed or kicked into the bush.
I see. Wait, we can't jump to any conclusions. How could this even be possible?
The girl dino turn into a boy dino?
With Dr. Wu's slapdash approach to gene sequencing, anything could go wrong.
Trodon, what else can you tell me about them?
Well, they're nocturnal. They're intelligent, like raptors, but they don't hunt like them. They envenomate with a single bite, then back off. Stalk their prey. Their teeth are serrated and retain saliva, and the saliva is saturated with the toxin.
Nima's bite. It was from a Trodon?
Yes, definitely.
What can you remember about that animal that bit you?
I didn't see it when it attacked. It went by so fast. It was dark. After it bit me, I became confused, like I'd been drugged. I remember there were many of them. They had glowing eyes.
Glowing eyes?
Yeah. I don't see anything. Maybe it's clear.
Leave the door alone. We're not going back out that way.
Why not?
Because we aren't backtracking, and those damn creatures could still be out there.
What about this grate? It looks big enough for everyone.
And it looks like it's heading in the right direction.
Billy, did you find something?
No, nothing. Is everyone ready?
What about Decaf?
I took care of that.
It looked like you took something off him. And if he has something that will help us...
I didn't find anything. I took his dog tags. Insurance doesn't pay out to his family unless his dog tags are returned. Satisfied?
Right. Sorry for pushing. Should we bring him with us?
Why bother? He's already buried. Look, I know where his body is. We're not equipped to transport it. Hopefully, we can retrieve his remains when this is all over. Everything that just happened, bygones, understand? Tell me again about the phones.
According to the terminal in my lab, the marine exhibit phones are still connected to the transceiver. The visitor center phones
are... Too far away, okay? And we can get to the exhibit through the tunnels?
They're all interconnected. I think I can still find...
The answer is yes. Thank you. All right, we all have the same priorities here now. We get to this marine exhibit and find the phone. We get another chopper in the air to lift us out from there.
How are we gonna get there? Troodon could still be out there.
We aren't equipped to treat any more bites. We have to...
Shh!
I will not be shushed.
The door.
Oh no.
Dad! They're coming through the vent!
Going past the door.
Gary, get that grate open!
Ugh!
God, Jess! What have I done? I just left her down there! I have to go find her!
What? Back down there? With those monsters? No, Jerry. She needs you safe. Jess is a strong and resourceful girl. She's doing like we are doing. Surviving.
You can't know that! I won't leave her to those animals!
Jerry, look at me. If we go back down there, we won't make it to the bottom of that ladder. The others escaped down the tunnel we were gonna follow. We know where they're going.
The marine exhibit. That's where Laura would take her.
And Yoder is with them.
Oh, God.
If we're going to join them again, that is where we have to go. The quickest way we can.
You're right. We should be able to make better time over land.
Can you get us there?
We pump seawater in from the lagoon. They must have built the marine exhibit near the waterworks.
Lagoon? I think I know where that is. Let me get my bearings, and we'll figure out how to get there. Por el amor de Dios.
Do you know where we are?
Let me think. It's been so long. This is my first time back on the island in nearly 12 years. Engine has changed it so much.
What does it have to do with you?
I grew up here, you know? Below those trees. Family. Everyone. My whole tribe. This had been our home for thousands of years. These monsters. There was never anything like them on this island before. It was all very peaceful before Injun bought the island from Costa Rica.
I didn't realize this island had been inhabited before. Injun moved your people?
They promised us homes and medicine. Education.
They didn't keep their promise.
The homes were slums and the medicine was extra or half-used or contaminated. We had schools, but no teachers. The island is so different now. I know the island. It's part of me. But when Injun came to the island, important men from Costa Rica came and asked my father to go back with them. They wanted my father to make a good impression, so that Costa Rica could ask Injun for a good deal of money for our island.
Spared no expense. Hammond. The man who made all this. He runs Injun. It's something he always says. He'll spend whatever it takes to make the park a success.
So, he spent it all on the dinosaurs. Not on my people. When Injun came to move us to Costa Rica, I became very angry with my father. Whatever he would tell me to do, I would refuse. But he would never be angry with me. He would say that I am a fish who would never eat the fisher's bait. He was right. To me, everything had a string attached.
You remind me of Jess. Do you still blame him for everything?
No. I have forgiven him. I know to blame Injun now. He would always remind me of my stubbornness. I think I believe that's how I must always be. You know, no ties, no temptation. But then I had Atlanta, my Mariquita. I named her after the city. That's where I will take her after this job. I want for her to have opportunities that I didn't have.
I'm sorry about what Injun has done to your island. This isn't the way things should have been done.
I don't blame you, Jerry. Shh.
Guest Dilophosaurus?
Hello?
That was actually the call of a whooping swan. Dinosaurs shared many features with modern-day birds. For instance, we now know that many theropod dinosaurs from the Jurassic period's vocal organs are just like modern birds. We are arriving at the fourth of seven lookouts along the tour. Your Jurassic Park tour vehicle will stop for 5 minutes to let you stretch your legs and take photographs of our animals. Next stop, the Jurassic Park Marine Facility and Aquarium.
What are they?
They look like feeder tanks. This could be a hatchery.
A hatchery what?
They're raising these fish to feed another animal, like at Marine World.
Like the killer whales?
Precisely.
Some tells me these fish aren't for feeding whales, huh, Doc? Hold up. All clear.
Dad!
Jess! Are you okay? Are you hurt?
No, I'm okay. Just
Can we go home now?
I'm so glad you two are safe, Jerry. How did you manage to get here?
We climbed out of the tunnels through a service hatch near one of the tour routes. Luckily, someone left the tour program running. Thanks.
You mean...
Dr. Sorkin, the phones are not working.
I'm sorry?
There is no dial tone. You said the phones would be working here.
That's odd. My control terminal showed that the main lines here were active. Unless... Of course. Everything is controlled by the computer systems, even the phones. If the power outage outlasted the battery backups, then the system is probably just waiting to be booted up.
Get us to the phones, Doc. We don't have a lot of time.
I refuse to be pushed around by you any longer.
Look, this isn't a day trip. If we don't contact InGen and get another helicopter out here for you all, the next flight over the island is going to be a wing of B-52s carrying holy hellfire.
What?
That's right, Doc. We're going to murder all your precious little pets and sink this island into the Pacific.
Dios mio. That's what you meant by Ground Zero?
Yeah, that's right.
Why didn't you tell me earlier? This is my home!
What do you mean, your home? I didn't tell you earlier because I thought we'd be off the island by now.
Wait. What is Dr. Sorkin doing?
Laura?
Wait, what are you...
Where is she going?
I don't know. This rotunda. It's where the control room is. She's going to the phones without us.
Damn it! Get that elevator back up here!
Hey! Don't open that. Are you crazy? Someone will see.
Relax.
See what?
Damn it, you careless idiot.
What was that thing? Some kind of spy gear?
Yeah, that's right. Top secret. In fact, if you tell anyone about it, I'll have to kill you.
You won't lay a finger on her.
I was just kidding around.
Everyone, I got the elevator working.
About time.
What's going on here?
Nothing. You're all cool. Oh, jeez, get over it. Let's go. We don't got all day.
Dad, my ears.
Attention.
What's going on?
The Lagoon Rotunda and Spectacular is housed in a pressurized underwater environment. We suggest you pinch your nose and push your breath to equalize your ears while we descend. If you experience any lasting discomfort or feel unusually giddy, let your attendant know immediately.
Giddy?
They're talking about nitrogen narcosis. It's a risk of breathing pressurized air.
What makes you the expert?
I saw it in a movie.
Whoa! Is that where we're going?
I think so. My God, wasn't expecting any of this.
This is so cool.
Careful, I'll lead.
Cool, look at that.
I want to speak with Hammond. No, this can't wait. Can you connect me to Mr. McGuire? Or no, Peter Ludlow. Please hurry. No, look. This is Dr. Laura
Sorkin. Oh, I have a bad feeling about this.
I am still on the premises. Mr. Parker, I do not need rescuing. I do not want the bombing waylaid. I want it stopped. What? It's not contaminated. This is a wildlife preserve. These animals are not diseased. They are extremely endangered.
Hey, Dad! This looks like an intercom up here.
Good find, honey. Laura?
Jerry, I hear you, and I'm glad you're here. This is going to be a lot easier now.
What have you been doing?
We're gonna stop the bombing, Jerry. This island must be preserved. I have taken the remaining survivors hostage. There are four others, three Americans and one Costa Rican. I won't let them go unless the plans to bomb the island are completely rescinded.
You have no right to hold us like this!
Rights are just an ideological construct.
Don't turn this into a philosophy debate!
What rights do the dinosaurs have? Don't they have the right to survive? Do their rights outweigh any of ours?
It is not our rights versus theirs. Our dinosaurs are phantoms. Majestic as they may be, alive as they may be, we brought them into a world that is no longer prepared for them. We have a responsibility to keep them isolated and under rein for the safety of our ecosystem. It's not rights, it's responsibility.
And we have a responsibility to preserve our creations and allow them a chance to survive on their own terms.
Will InGen stop the bombing?
Doubt it. InGen is not the one dropping bombs, it's the U.S. military. And the contingency is based around a biohazard cover story. She may just be delaying the inevitable.
If you don't offer me some sort of guarantee that the island will be preserved, I will have to escalate matters.
This is lunacy! Fine, put the military on the phone. Hello? Hello? You want to see contamination of the global ecosystem?
Laura?
I'm going to free the Mosasaur.
Are you mad? A land dinosaur paddling to the mainland is one thing. But you're talking about releasing an apex predator into over 70% of the global ecosystem.
It's only one. It can be recaptured.
Before it eats the last of the humpbacks?
Oh, don't be dramatic.
Laura, don't.
Plan B.
I'm sorry, Jerry. For the sake of this island and the scientific treasure it holds, I have been forced to take an action.
It's not too late. We can reverse this.
No. I locked the system down. There's nothing you can do. I've opened the gates and the Mosasaur is free to leave.
Laura, you have to—
No, Jerry. This isn't up for debate. We have to show InGen—
Look out!
Everybody, be cool. And stay away from the window.
Be cool?
That's right. What? You want an I told you so? I don't know about you, but I came here to make a phone call. Hello. This is William Yoder, ID 4122. Put me through to Haskell. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The U.S. Embassy. Report as follows. The island is completely overrun. Alpha team killed in action, save one, myself. Bravo team killed in action. Two helicopters disabled. Two civilian casualties. I have access to a seaworthy boat and I will evacuate the remaining survivors. Yes, sir. 90 minutes. Understood, sir.
What's happening? Who did you call?
That's far enough.
What?
You're not coming with me. There's going to be a tragic accident, Jerry. Nima, we have everything we need. We're finishing this without them.
What?
No.
What do you mean, no? We've got an agreement, remember?
An agreement doesn't involve killing Jerry and Jess.
What's going on?
I'm sorry, Jerry. I was sent here to retrieve dinosaur embryos from InGen.
I don't understand. You're a corporate spy?
Yes.
Damn it, Nima! I trusted you!
It's not like that. Yoder took the can. He wants it for himself.
What can?
A can of shaving cream.
It has a compartment to smuggle the embryos off the island.
Damn it, Nima. You're blowing it!
No, you are. Oscar put his faith in you. He may have been a devil, but he wore his sins on his arm for everyone to see. You are just a mask with nothing behind it.
No, you can't do this! Don't you care? Don't you care about Oscar or Decap?
That's enough! Everyone stay back! I'm gonna give you a sporting chance here.
Billy,
once
wait.
I let go of the spoon, there ain't no coming back.
Don't do this! Is everyone all right?
You mean, besides being trapped in this bubble by that desgraciado, we're as good as dead?
Don't say that. Somebody might, somebody will come for us.
Oh, Jerry. Yoder left us here. He'll take the boat and not tell anyone about us.
Maybe he won't take the boat.
He has the canister. He knows where the boat is.
He, doesn't have the canister.
What?
I'm sorry. I promise not to steal anymore.
Okay,
but
that one's a freebie.
Jerry, look!
Oh, great. Just great.
Why is it flooding?
Must be the damage to the door. We're losing air pressure. This place will flood right up to the highest hole in the room. Damn it!
Wait a second. I remember.
Maybe there still is a way out. If we swim.
Swim? We won't make it 20 feet with that Mosasaur swimming around.
Maybe. Look at that pipeline. It leads out of this lagoon. There are caves at the far end. Those caves connect to others that lead back to the beaches. We use the pipeline as cover.
And you think we can hold our breath the whole way?
Dad, look! There's diving gear!
We don't know the first thing about scuba diving.
Dad, don't mess with the mixture valve. They're all preset.
Since when do you know about diving?
Remember those lessons you wouldn't let me take?
Did your mother override my decision?
Yeah.
Do we need the wetsuits? The water should be warm.
This deep, and this time of the day, we would totally go hyperthermic. Don't worry, Dad. Neoprene makes everyone look good.
It's not my modesty I'm worried about. Are you sure about these sea caves?
I used to swim this lagoon as a child. With the air tanks, it'll be easy.
Famous last words.
Pardon?
I'll be right back. That ought to keep it busy. Okay, hon. What do we do?
Dad, I changed my mind. These are rebreathers and I've never actually used one. I'm not ready for this.
Hey, you can do this.
No! What if something goes wrong? I don't want to do this. I don't want anyone else to get hurt.
No, it's okay, hon. No teenager should ever have to go through something like this. But look how far we've come. You've been so incredibly brave. You can do this. I will be with you every step of the way.
I just don't want you to go away. I'm so tired of you always going away.
I know, honey, but I'm here right now, and I'm not gonna leave you alone. I'll be here with you all the way. Now, what's the diver signal for okay?
It's universal. Duh.
Right. Well, I promise to signal you whenever you check on me, okay?
Let's do this.
Look, by the lighthouse.
Yes, that must be it.
I don't see anyone on it.
Maybe a dinosaur ate them.
Well, well, well. Fortune smiles upon the brave.
Hey, Dad!
I thought I'd worked everything out. Hadn't accounted for a little thief here. I was sure I had buried my ticket off this island at the bottom of the sea.
You bastard. What will your bosses think when they learn that you tried to murder us?
You're not gonna tell them. I just don't know how we got to this point, Nima. You were the last one of my kind I thought I could trust. Things didn't start out that way, but we had worked out a mutually beneficial deal! But now, I don't even have that. All that's left for me is that damn canister. Ah! Nice one.
You looking for this?
You know, things don't have to be this way. We'll kiss and make up and share this payout just like we planned.
There is no more plan. We're leaving without you.
Come on, Nima. You're a merc just like me. You got bills to pay? Are these two really worth all this?
They are worth more than your pathetic life. I would trade your life even for Oscar's.
Our deal.
Do you feel that?
Oh my god. Stop!
You want to make new friends?
Yoder!
Thank you.
We made it. Believe me, the whole world is better off without that can.
Guys?
Not me, Joey. Not my daughter.
Guys?
Nima, I made a promise. I'll figure something out. Come back to Dallas with us. We'll find a way to get you and your Mariquita.
Guys! How much did you say those embryos were worth?